Hi students, welcome to Vidyanagar online classes. As you all know, in our last class we were discussing about integers. So what are integers? Yes, the collection of whole numbers and negative numbers are integers. And what are negative numbers? Yes, the numbers which are less than 0 are negative numbers. And we know that 0 is neither positive nor negative. And we have also discussed some questions from exercise 6.1. But before discussing some more questions from the exercise, look here. Suppose this is the number 9, as you can see here. And we know that 0 is at the center, and at the right side of the 0, positive numbers are there, as you can see. And at the left side of the 0, negative numbers are there. Okay? Then, if I ask you, suppose minus 5 and minus 3. If I ask you which number is greater, minus 5 or minus 3, can you check? Yes, minus 3 will be greater. Why minus 3 is greater? Because if you see on the number line, minus 3 is at the right side of minus 5. Okay, so the number which is at the right side will always be greater. Okay, you can see clearly from here that minus 3 is at the right side of minus 5. So minus 3 is greater. Okay, and one more thing you can tell, if you look at these two numbers, minus 5 and minus 3, which number is having less negative value? So you can see that minus 3 is having less negative value, that's why minus 3 is greater. If I ask you which number is greater, minus 20 or minus 10, which number is greater out of these two numbers? Yes, minus 10 is greater. Why? Because if you extend this number line, then you can see that minus 10 will be at the right side. So minus 10 is greater. So always remember that the number which is at the right side will be greater than the number which is at the left side in the number line. Always remember that. Okay. Now let us do the remaining questions of the exercise 6.1. See what is the sixth question. In each of the following pairs, which number is to the right of the other on the number line? This pair is given. So you have to tell which number will be at the right side on the number line. So I have already told you the number which is greater will be at the right side and the number which is smaller will be at the left side. So 2 and 9 is given. So which number is greater out of 2 and 9? Yes, 9 is greater. So 9 will be at the right of 2. If you can draw the number line also, see here. The number lines will be like this. 0 will be at the middle. Then at the right side, positive numbers will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. And at the left side, negative numbers will be there. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like this. So, the number which is greater will be at the right side. Okay? As you can see here, 3 is at the right side of 2. Why? Because 3 is greater than 2. Okay, so likewise, out of 2 and 9, which number is greater? 9 is greater. So 9 will be at the right side of 2. So you can write 9 is at right of 2. Okay, now let us do the B part. See what is the B part? We have to tell out of minus 3 and minus 8, which number is to the right of the other on the number line. So we know that the number which is greater will be at the right of the other number. So out of minus 3 and minus 8, which number is greater? Yes, minus 3 is greater because it is at the right side of minus 8. You can also see it by drawing the number line. You can see here. See, this is the number line. Okay. Then suppose 0 is here. Then positive numbers will be at the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this, and negative numbers will be at left side, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8 like this. So you can see here that minus 3 is at right of minus 8. Okay, so we can write it, minus 3 is at right of minus 8. Why is it at right of minus 8? Because minus 3 is greater than minus 8. Now let us do the C part. What is the C part? We have to tell out of 0 and minus 1 which will be at the right of the other. So you can see that 0 is greater than minus 1. So 0 will be at the right side. You can see in number line also 0 is at the right side. So we can write here 0 is at right of minus 1. Now let us do the E part. See what is the E part? Out of minus 6 and 6, we have to tell which number will be at the right of the other. So you can tell out of minus 6 and 6 which number is greater? Yes, 6 is greater. So 6 will be at the right of minus 6. So you can write it, 6 is at right of minus 6. Why? Because 6 is a greater number. Now, out of 1 and minus 100, in minus 100 in F part, which number will be at the right side? Which is greater out of 1 and minus 100? Yes, 1 is greater because it is a positive number. Okay? And it is a negative number. So, positive numbers are always greater than negative number. So, 1 will be at the right side of minus 100. 1 is at right of minus 100. Why? Because 1 is greater than minus 100. Now let us do the 7th question. See what is the 7th question. Write all integers between the given pairs. Write them in increasing order. Okay, the pair is given and we have to write all the integers between the given pair in increasing order. Increasing order means in ascending order. That is from small to big. So the given pair is 0 and minus 7. First of all, let us simply write what are the integers between 0 and minus 7. So you know that the integers between 0 and minus 7 are minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and minus 6. So these are the integers between 0 and minus 7. But we have to arrange them in increasing order as it is given in the question. We have to arrange them in increasing order. That means from small to big. So if you see these integers, which is the smallest one? Yes, minus 6 is the smallest, because if you draw the number line, then minus 6 will be at the left side. Okay, so minus 6 is the smallest one. So first of all, minus 6 will come. Then after minus 6, yes, minus 5. Then minus 4. Then minus 3. Then minus 2. And the biggest one is minus 1. So this is the increasing order of all the integers between the given pair 0 and minus 7. Okay. Now let us do the B part. We have to write all the integers between the pairs minus 4 and 4 in the increasing order. So first of all, let us write the integers between minus 4 and 4 simply. Okay. So if you write it, the integers between minus 4 and 4 will be 3 will be there, 2 will be there, 1 will be there, then 0 will be there, minus 1 will be there, minus 2 and minus 3. So these are the integers between minus 4 and 4. You can also see it if you draw the number line, then you can clearly see that these are the integers between minus 4 and 4. But we have to arrange them in increasing order. That means from small to big. Okay. So which is the smallest one out of these? Yes, the smallest one is minus 3, because if you draw the number line, then you can see that minus 3 is at the left side among these numbers. So minus 3 will be the smallest, then minus 2, then minus 1, then 0, 1, 2 and 3 is the biggest one. So this is the increasing order of the given pair of integers. Between these two integers, this is the increasing order of the integers. Okay. Now let us do the C part. In C part also, we have to write the integers between the given pairs in increasing order. The given pair is minus 8 and minus 15. So we can, first of all, we will write the integers between them simply. Okay. So what will be the integers between these two numbers? Yes, minus 9 will be there, minus 10 will be there, then minus 11 is also there, minus 12, minus 13 and minus 14. So these are the integers between minus 8 and minus 15. But this is not the increasing order. We have to arrange them in increasing order. That means first of all we will write the smallest number. So which is the smallest integer out of these? Yes, minus 14 is the smallest integer, because if you draw the number line, then you can see that minus 14 will be at the left side among these integers. Okay, so minus 14 will come first. Then after minus 14, yes, minus 13, then minus 12, then minus 11, then minus 10, and then minus 9. So this is the increasing order of the integers between minus 8 and minus 15. Okay, now let us do the 8th question of this exercise. See what is the 8th question. A part is, write 4 negative integers greater than minus 20. We have to write 4 negative integers which are greater than minus 20. As I have already told you that the number which is having more negative value is always smaller. Suppose if you take minus 19, and if I ask you out of minus 20 and minus 19, which number is greater? Yes, minus 19 is greater, because minus 19 is having less negative value. Okay, so minus 19 is always greater than minus 20. And then we have to write 4 such negative integers which are greater than minus 20. So you can write minus 19 is there, minus 18, minus 17, minus 16. They all are greater than minus 20. Why? Because they have less negative value. Okay, now let us do the B part. See what is the B part. Write 4 negative integers less than minus 10. Now we have to write 4 negative integers which are less than minus 10. That means, less than means we have to write such integers which are having more negative value than minus 10. So you can write it minus 11. It is less than minus 10 because it has more negative value than minus 10. Minus 11, minus 12, minus 13, minus 14, they all are less than minus 10, since they all are having more negative value than minus 10. Okay, now let us do the 9th question of this exercise. See what is the 9th question. For the following statements, write true or false. We have to write true or false. If the statement is false, then we have to correct the statement. Okay, see the first part. A part, minus 8 is to the right of minus 10 on the number line. They are asking whether minus 8 is to the right of minus 10 on number line. So if you see minus 8 and minus 10, which number is greater? Yes, minus 8 is greater. Why? Because minus 8 is having less negative value. Okay, and we know that the number which is greater is always at the right side of the number which is smaller. So out of minus 8 and minus 10, which number will be at the right side on number line? Yes, minus 8 will be on the right side, since minus 8 is greater than minus 10. So this statement is true. Okay, now see the B part. Minus 100 is the right of minus 50 on number 9. So if you see minus 100 and minus 50, which number is greater? Yes, minus 50 is greater, because minus 50 is having less negative value. Minus 100 is having more negative value. So minus 50 is greater. So minus 50 will be at the right side on number line, not minus 100 will be on the right side of the number line. Minus 50 will be on the right side of the number line. So it is false. Then you have to correct this statement. So when you correct it, you can write it, minus 50 will be at the right side of minus 100 on the number line. Understood? So what you will write? You will write minus 50 will be on the right side of minus 100 on the number line. Now let us do the C part of the same question. The smallest negative integer is minus 1. You have to tell whether it is true or false. Is minus 1 the smallest negative integer? Suppose if you draw the number line, see here. This is the number line, suppose that. Okay, then 0 is here. Then negative integers will be this side, minus 1, minus 2, like this. And positive integers are at the right side, like this. So if you see, is minus 1 the smallest negative integers? Minus 1 is even at the right side of minus 2. And many other negative integers, minus 1 will be at the right side of all other negative integers. So that means minus 1 is not the smallest negative integer. So it is false. Okay, so what will be its correct statement? The correct statement will be largest negative integer is minus 1. So what can you write to correct the statement? You can write largest negative integer is minus 1. Okay, now see the D part. Minus 26 is larger than minus 25. If you see minus 26 and minus 25, which is greater? Yes, minus 25 is greater because it is having less negative value than minus 26. So that means it is also false. So what will you write to correct this statement? You will write that minus 26 is smaller than minus 25. So that will be the correct statement. Understood? Now let us do the 10th question. See what is the 10th question? Draw a number line and answer the following. We have to draw the number line and then we have to answer. See what is the A part? Which number will we reach if we move 4 number to the right of minus 2? Okay. So first of all, let us draw the number line. See here. This is the number line. 0 will be at the middle. At the right side, positive numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this, all the positive numbers will be at the right side of 0 and the negative numbers like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, they all will be at the left side. Now, what we have to do? We have to move 4 numbers to the right of minus 2. Where is minus 2? Is here. From here, we have to move 4 numbers to the right side. See, first number, second, third, fourth. So where we reach after moving 4 numbers to the right of minus 2? We reach at 2. So the answer will be 2. We will reach at 2 if we move 4 numbers to the right of minus 2. Understood? Now let us do the D part of the same question. If we are at minus 6 on the number line, in which direction should we move to reach minus 1? So they are asking, on the number line, you are at minus 6. Then in which direction you have to move to reach minus 1? So first of all, let us draw a number line. See here, this is the number line. Okay. 0 will be at the middle. At the right side, positive numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like this, all the positive numbers. And at the left side, negative numbers. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, like this, all the negative numbers will be at the left side. Now, if we are at minus 6, that means you are at minus 6 and you want to reach at minus 1 here. So, in which direction you have to move? Yes, you have to move right side to reach minus 1 from minus 6. So, you can write, we have to move right side. Okay, right side. So I hope you understood it. So now our exercise 6.1 is completed. Now look here. Sometimes the questions are like this. Using the number line, write the integer which is 2 more than 3. That means you have to draw the number line like this, as you can see. Then what you have to do after marking the integers, what you have to do, since the question is given 2 more than 3. Okay, you have to write the integer which is 2 more than 3 using the number line. So, see first of all, see where is 3? 3 is this here. Okay, then you have to write the integer which is 2 more than 3. 2 more than 3. If it is given more than, that means you have to take the steps right side. Okay, since it is 2 more than 3, so you have to take 2 steps right side of 3. So, see first step. Second step. So where you reach? You reach at 5. So 2 more than 3 is equal to 5. Understood? Now if the question is like this, using the number line, write the integer which is 6 less than 2. Now it is 6 less than 2. So what you will do? First of all, you will draw the number line and at the right side of 0, you will write the positive integers and at the left side, you will write the negative integers. And after that, you have to write the integer which is 6 less than 2. So first of all, see where is 2? 2 is here. You can see it. Okay. Now you have to write the integer which is 6 less than 2. Now it is given less than. If it is given less than, that means you have to take the steps left side. Okay, always remember that. If it is given more than, then you have to take the steps right side. If it is given less than, then you have to take the steps left side. So now we have to take 6 steps left side of 2. So take it. First step, second step, third step, fourth step, fifth step, and sixth step. So where you reach? You reach at minus 4. So the integer which is 6 less than 2 is equal to minus 4. So these questions you can do like this. Understood? Now let us learn addition of integers using number line. That means how to add the integers using number line. So first of all, what you have to do for that, suppose you want to add 3 and 2, that is 3 plus 2 using number line. So what you will do, first of all, you will draw a number line. Okay, after drawing the number line, what you have to do, at the right side of 0, you will mark positive numbers, and at the left side of 0, you will mark negative numbers. Okay, so now suppose you want to add 3 and 2. So first of all, see where is 3. Since 3 is a positive number, as you can see, so 3 will be at the right side of 0. So how many steps you need to take from 0 to reach to 3? So you need 3 steps. So this is 3. So now you reach at 3. You have to take 3 steps right side from 0 to reach 3. So now you reach at 3. Now you want to add 2 to this 3. Okay, and 2 is also a positive number. So again you have to take 2 steps right side from 3. Since 2 is a positive number, so you have to take 2 steps right side from 3. So now if you take 2 steps from 3, then you will reach at 5. So 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. So like this you can add the integers using number line. Okay. Now suppose the question is minus 1 plus minus 6. That means you want to add minus 1 and minus 6 using number line. So what you will do? You will first of all draw the number line, and after marking the integers, what you have to do? You have to see where is minus 1. So as you can see, minus 1 is a negative integer. So it will be at the left side of 0. Okay? So where is minus 1? Minus 1 is at the left side of 0. So from 0 you have to take 1 step left side to reach minus 1. Okay? So 1 step, now you reach at minus 1. Now you want to add minus 6 to this minus 1. So again you can see that minus 6 is a negative number. That means you have to take 6 steps left side of minus 1 since it is a negative number. So if you take 6 steps left side of minus 1, where will you reach? You can count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You will reach at minus 7. Okay? So you reach at minus 7. So minus 1 plus minus 6 is equal to minus 7. Understood? So what we have done here? First of all, we will see where is minus 1. As you know that minus 1 is a negative number, it will be at the left side of 0. So we take 1 step left side of 0 to reach minus 1. And then we have to add minus 6 to this minus 1. Since minus 6 is also a negative number, so we have to take 6 steps left side of minus 1. And when you take 6 steps left side of minus 1, you will reach to minus 7. So the answer to the given question is minus 7. Understood? Now let us learn the addition of integers without using number line. Till now we have learned the addition of integers using number line. Now we will learn the addition of integers without using number line. Suppose you want to add 2 and 3 without using number line. So how will you add it? Look here, this one, this box. As you can see, if both the numbers are positive, okay, as you see here, 2 and 3, both are positive numbers, then you will simply add them, okay, and put the sign of the bigger number, okay. So if you simply add them up, 2 and 3, what you will get? You will get 5. 2 plus 3, we know that is 5, and we have to put the sign of the bigger number. Which is the bigger number here? 3 is bigger than 2. So the sign on 3 is positive, since it is a positive number. So the answer will be in a positive sign. Okay, so 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Understood? So if both the numbers are positive, then we will simply add them up and put the sign of the bigger number. Now see this. If you want to add minus 2 and minus 3, that means if you see here, both the numbers are negative. Minus 2 is also negative number, minus 3 is also negative number. So as you can see in the box I have written, if both the numbers are negative, then also we will simply add them and put the sign of the bigger number. So first of all, let us add them. If you add simply 2 and 3, what you will get? If you add 2 and 3, 2 plus 3, that is 5. But now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. So which is the bigger number out of this 2 and 3? 3 is the bigger number and it is having a negative sign, as you can see here. So in answer, you will put the negative sign. Okay. Now if you want to add 2 and minus 3. Okay. So as you can see here, one number is positive and one number is negative. Now look here. Here also I have given, if one number is positive and one number is negative, then we will subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. Okay. So first of all, since one number is positive and one is negative, first of all we will subtract them. So if you subtract 2 from 3, what you will get? 3 minus 2 is? Yes, you will get 3 minus 2 is 1. And now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. Okay. So out of 2 and 3, which is bigger number? Yes, 3 is a bigger number. And 3 is having a negative sign. So here also in answer, you will put the negative sign. Understood? Okay. Now look to this question. You want to add minus 2 and plus 3. That means positive 3 and minus 2. So as you can see here, one number is negative and one is positive. So what we will do now? We will subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. So first of all, let us subtract. So if you subtract 2 from 3, what you will get? 3 minus 2? You will again get 1. But now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. So out of 2 and 3, which is bigger number? Yes, 3 is a bigger number and 3 is a positive number. So we will put the sign of plus. You can put plus 1 or simply you can write 1. Both are correct. Okay? Understood? Now suppose you want to add these integers. Minus 7, plus 2, plus minus 3. You want to add them. So how will you add them? First of all, see these two numbers only. Okay? So if you see these two numbers, one number is negative, that is minus 7, and the other number is positive, that is plus 2. And we have learned that if one number is negative and one is positive, then we will subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. So first of all, if you subtract 2 from 7, what you will get? If you subtract 2 from 7, 7 minus 2 is 5. But now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. So which number is bigger, 7 or 2? Yes, 7 is bigger and the sign on 7 is negative sign. So we will put here negative sign. Now write this number as it is, plus minus 3. Understood? Now see, both the numbers are negative. Minus 5 is also negative, minus 3 is also negative. And we have learned that if both the numbers are negative, then we will add them and put the sign of the bigger number. Okay, so first of all we will add them. So 5 plus 3 is 8, we know that 5 plus 3 is 8. Now put the sign of the bigger number, since both the numbers are negative and so the bigger number is also having the negative sign. So we can put here negative sign. So minus 5 plus minus 3 is equal to minus 8. Understood? So this is our final answer to this question. I hope you understood it. Now let us move to our exercise, that is exercise 6.2. See what is the first question. Using number line, write the integers, which is B part I am going to do 5 more than minus 5. So first of all, what we will do? We will draw the number line. Okay, see here. Okay. Then here is 0. and at the right side of 0 positive numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this, and at the left side of 0 negative numbers minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 like this. Now the question is, we have to write the integers which is 5 more than minus 5. So first of all, see where is minus 5 on the number line. Since it is a negative number, it will be on the left side of 0. So minus 5 is here. Now we have to write the integer which is 5 more than minus 5. That means it is given more than. So we have to take the steps right side. 5 steps right side to of minus 5. Okay, so if you take 5 steps from here, where will you reach? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You will reach at 0. So the integer which is 5 more than minus 5 is equal to 0. Understood? Now let us do the C part of the same question. Okay, we have to write the integer which is 6 less than 2. So first of all, we will draw the number line. Okay, so this is the number line. 0 is here, and at the right side positive numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this, and at the left side negative numbers minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 like this. Now what we have to do, we have to write the integers which is 6 less than 2. So where is 2? Since 2 is a positive number, it will be at the right side of 0. So here is 2. So now we have to write the integer which is 6 less than 2. Less than, it is given less than. So that means we have to take the steps left side. How many steps we have to take left side? 6 steps left side of 2. So now you take 6 steps left side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So where you reach? You reach at minus 4. So 6 less than 2 is equal to minus 4. Understood? Now let us do the second question of the exercise 6.2. See what is the second question? Use number line and add the following. Okay? First, A part is 9 plus minus 6. We want to add 9 and minus 6 using number line. So what we will do? First of all, we will draw the number line. Okay? So see, this is the number line. Suppose 0 is here. Then positive numbers at the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like this, all the positive numbers will be at the right side and negative numbers on the left side. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, like this. And now what you have to do? You have to add 9 and minus 6 using number line. So since 9 is a positive number, so it will be at the right side of 0. So from 0, how many steps you need? To reach to 9, you need 9 steps. So where is 9? 9 is here. So from 0, you will take 9 steps and reach at 9. This is 9. Now you want to add minus 6 to this 9. So minus 6 is a negative number. So that means you have to take 6 steps left side of 9. So if you take 6 steps left side of 9, where you will reach, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You will reach at 3. Okay? So where you reach at 3. So the final answer to this question is, when you add 9 and minus 6, you will get 3. Understood? Now let us do the B part of the same question. Here you have to add 5 and minus 11 using number line. So first of all, what we will do? We will draw the number line. Okay? So this is the number line. 0 is here. Okay? At the right side, positive numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this. And at the left side, negative numbers, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. Now you want to add 5 and minus 11. So, see 5 is a positive number, so it will be at the right side of 0. So, how many steps you need to take to reach 5 from 0? 5 steps. So, you reach at 5 from 0. Now, you want to add minus 11 to this 5. Since minus 11 is a negative number, so you have to take 11 steps left side of 5. Okay? So, if you take 11 steps, count where will you reach? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You will reach at minus 6. Okay? So, 5 plus minus 11 is equal to minus 6. Understood? Now, let us do the E part of the same question. Now, we have to add minus 1 and minus 2 and minus 3 using number line. So, what we will do? First of all, we will draw the number line. Okay? So, this is the number line. Okay? And we know that 0 is here. Okay? Positive numbers are at the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this. And negative numbers on the left side. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6 like this. Now, first of all, we have to see where is minus 1. Since minus 1 is a negative number, it will be at the left side of 0. So, we have to take one step left side of 0 to reach minus 1. So, you took one step and you reach at minus 1. Now, you want to add minus 2 to this minus 1. That means, again, you have to take two steps left side of minus 1 since minus 2 is a negative number. Okay? So, you took two steps left side of minus 1. Then, where you reach? You reach at minus 3. Now, again, you want to add minus 3 to this number. Okay? So, again, you have to take three steps left side from here, from minus 3, since minus 3 is a negative number. So, when you take three steps left side of minus 3, you will reach at minus 6. So, what is the answer of this question? Minus 6. Understood? Now, let us do the third question. In third question, we have to add without using number line. Okay? A part is 11 plus minus 7. That means we have to add 11 and minus 7 without using number line. So, as you can see, one number is positive and one is negative number. So, you see here, if one number is positive and one is negative, then we subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. Okay? So, if you subtract 11, 7 from 11, what you will get? 11 minus 7, you will get 4. And now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. Which is the bigger number? 11 or 7? Yes, 11 is the bigger number and 11 is a positive number. So, 4 will also be a positive number. Okay, so 11 minus 7 is equal to 4. That is the final answer. Now, let us do the B part of the same question. Now, you want to add minus 13 and plus 18 without using number line. So, as you can see here, one number is negative and one number is positive. So, see here, if one number is negative and one is positive, then we will subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. Okay? So, if you subtract 13 from 18, that means 18 minus 13, what you will get? You will get 5. Okay? And now put the sign of the bigger number. Which is the bigger number, 13 or 18? Yes, 18 is the bigger number. So, the final answer will be plus 5. Okay? Now, let us do the E part. In E part, you want to add minus 380 and minus 270 without using the number line. Okay? So, as you can see, both the numbers are negative. This is also negative and this is also negative. And I have already told you, both the numbers are negative, then we will add them and put the sign of the bigger number. So first of all, you will add 380 and 270. So when you add 380 and 270, what you will get? You can add them and then you will see that you will get 650. Okay? And now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. So since both the numbers are negative, the bigger number is also negative. So we will put the negative sign. Okay? So the answer is minus 650. Now let us do the fourth question. See what is the fourth question? Find the sum of A part is 137 and minus 354. So we want to add them. Okay, 137 plus minus 354. So as you can see, one number is positive and other one is negative. And we know that if one number is positive and other is negative, then we subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. So first of all, let us subtract. So if you subtract 137 from 354, what you will get? You can see here, you will get 7, here you will get 1, to 270. What you will get? You will get 270. Now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. So which is the bigger number, 137 or 354? Yes, 354 is the bigger number and it is having a negative sign. So here also we have to put the negative sign. So this is our final answer. Now let us do the D part of the same question. In D part, we have to find the sum of minus 50, minus 200 and 300. So we want to add them. Minus 50 plus minus 200 plus 300. Okay. So first of all, we will see these two numbers. Okay. So if you see, both the numbers are negative. This is also negative and this is also negative. And we know that if both the numbers are negative, then we will add them up. Okay. So if you add 50 and 200, what you will get? 200 plus 50 is equal to 250. And then put the sign of the bigger number. So both the numbers are negative. So we will put the negative sign. Then write this number as it is, plus 300. Now if you see, one number is negative and the other one is positive. That means we have to subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. So if you subtract 250 from 300, what you will get? You can check. When you subtract 250 from 300, you will get 50. And now put the sign of the bigger number. Which is the bigger number? 250 or 300? Yes, 300 is the bigger number and it is having a positive sign. So the answer will be in a positive sign. Now let us do the fifth question. See what is the fifth question? Find the value of A part is minus 7 plus minus 9 plus 4 plus 16. Okay, we have to add them. So first of all, see these two numbers. Okay, so both the numbers are negative. This is also negative and this is also negative. And we know that if both the numbers are negative, we will add them and put the sign of the bigger number. So if you add 7 and 9, you can see, if you add 7 and 9, you will get 16. So 16, and you have to put the sign of the bigger number. So here negative sign will come since 9 is having negative sign. Now write these two numbers as it is, plus 4 plus 16. Okay. Now see these two numbers. Now if you see these two numbers, one number is negative and other one is positive. And we know that if one number is negative and other is positive, then we subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. So if you subtract 4 from 16, what you will get? You can check. If you subtract 4 from 16, you will get 12. So we will write 12 and put the sign of the bigger number. Which is the bigger number, 16 or 4? Yes, 16 is the bigger number. So we will put the sign of negative sign. Okay. Now write this number as it is, plus 16. Okay. Now see these two numbers. One number is negative and other one is positive. So again, we will subtract them and put the sign of the bigger number. So if you subtract 12 from 16, what you will get? 16 minus 12 is we know that 16 minus 12 is 4. So we will write 4, and now you have to put the sign of the bigger number. So which is the bigger number, 12 or 16? Yes, 16 is the bigger number and it is having a positive sign. So this 4 will also have a positive sign. So the final answer is 4. I hope you understood it. So now we have completed our addition of integers using number line and also without using number line. So that's all in today's class. Thank you.